Ben All Hair Entertainment presents a We Are Grassroots mini docu-series featuring past and present players, starring legend coach Roy Russell, founder of Grassroots Elite Canada. Then you have myself, Coach Francis, CEO of Ben Out Here ENT. I'm also an alumni of the Grassroots program, and last year I had the pleasure of coaching a U16 team. There are moments we wish we could replay, and there were others where we came to. This year, my role is to help Coach Roy at any capacity that he needs, and to also coach the U17 team. Next, we got Tashin Kasambo, CEO of Vimitin Training, also lead coach of the U16.
Make sure you slide your feet, take pride on your defense. I know these guys are not that good, so don't let them beat you.
Once you guys play in the States, you guys will see the difference. Like, the speed of the game is a lot faster. So you have to be ready to play, you know? You have to have the intensity. You guys be a little bit aggressive, a little bit grinding, you know what I'm saying?
Assistant coach to sing with the 16 U team, we got Coach Arthur.
Hey, better effort, man. We just got to take care of the ball. And just end here. Look inside here. Not just screen down, he pop up, screen down, he pop up. That's too telegraphed, right?
We also got Coach Henry, two-time Humber College national champ and current lead coach of the U14 team. Last but not least, we got Coach D, Peel Region and Toronto legend, current lead coach of the U13s and CEO of True Balance Hoops.
It's money. That's one.
That's one. That's one. That's one. That's one.
Yeah. Big year, big year, big year, for sure.
Thank you.
2K23, let's get it.
1, 2, 3,
you know that saying, there's always light at the end of the tunnel? Here at Grassroots, we always strive for greatness. Coach Roy has spent the past 30 plus years working with and training young athletes across the country and abroad with the goal of helping them play at the next level. Over 1,000 players have worn a Grassroots jersey since its conception in 89. Hundreds have made it to play at the collegiate level, and out of those individuals, 13 have had a chance to play in the NBA, as well as countless others who have played professionally or overseas. NBA champions Corey Joseph and Tristan Thompson, both alumni of the program, have showed everyone in Toronto that all dreams are possible when you put in the work and stay focused. Signing with one of the, if not the best agent in the NBA, Rich Paul, and Clutch Sports Management.
Drafted Canadian ever. What's this mean for you and for Canada?
I mean, it's history, man. Hopefully we can repeat it, you know, next year with Andrew Wiggins coming in.
Critics wrong. How do you prove being the number one pick when you go into Cleveland?
Just going in and creating an impact off the bat, you know, just playing my game, have confidence in myself, you know, because I gotta believe in myself before anyone else can.
Anthony Bennett and Andrew Wiggins, first round, first overall draft picks, were huge for the city also, because ever since, the floodgates have been open for all Canadians. Coach Roy, how's it going, man?
Oh my God.
I'm Roy Russell.
Hey, I don't say that. This is Roy Russell. Founder.
Again, it can't be slurred.
I'm more nervous.
I mean, I'm nervous. After this, hey.
How you doing? This is Roy Russell, CEO and founder of Grassroots League Canada. Been doing this for 35 years.
I started Grassroots because I was from Jane and Finch, and I wanted to help the young men and women to have hope and have opportunities and extend their education to the post-secondary level. And I wanted to use basketball as a means to being focused and staying in school and being ambitious and, you know, just mentoring.
Number, name, information, so that it can help to enhance your opportunities to get a scholarship. Because at the end of the day, that's the only thing that I hold more dear than win the championship. Like right now, I don't care if we win a championship or not. I like to, right? But if guys get offers, that's the most important thing. Now, obviously, if you do both, that's great. Okay, so that's what we want to do. Clap it up, clap it up, clap it up.
Down here in Bryan, Texas, the three stripes gold bracket, trying to get back in the 3SSB bracket, and we had a little falter back in 2020 with the COVID situation happening. We couldn't get into the gyms, we couldn't practice, we didn't play AAU, there's no high school season.
I've been coaching at Grassroots for about 5 years now. I could say that I learned a lot through the process. It's not the only program that I've been coaching throughout my career, but it's the one that I could call home. Coach Roy has really given me the opportunity to help these young kids and help them get to the next level. I can't thank him enough. You know, with these opportunities and my experience, I know I can help the young generation and give back to the community tremendously. This current circuit, my team played very good, but at the beginning, they weren't focused. I had to, you know, bring them together. We had a team meeting, and in that team meeting, we kind of broke down everything and what we need from each player, clarified things that they liked and they disliked, and we got to talk to them about themselves and taking accountability, discipline, and, you know, becoming grown adults, because they are 17, they're getting ready to go to college, and you know, we're not gonna be there to walk with them and hold their hand. So they're gonna have to step up to the plate and get things done themselves.
That's a shot! There you go! Pass it off. There we go, perfect pass! All the way. There we go. Lay up. All the way. Lay up. I won, right?
This weekend we went 3-1. The first game was really just a game where it was the first time I was coaching. We had a couple guys come back from the previous season, but we also have a couple new guys that we had to integrate into the offense. So that was really fun. We won by about 21 points. I think what happened within that first game is we got a bit too high on that win, and it showed in our second game, in which was down pretty big. We managed to come back, but still lost by about 10 to 12 points. And then from that is just how we respond. We ended up winning our last two games, played with a lot of more grit, the game that we won, the most important game, after we suffered our first loss, we had a little team meeting just to talk about some of the things that we could have done better as a team. Then we knew we had a big game against TJ Ford. We knew we had to wake up for that. So in that game, it was a very exciting game. It was definitely a nail biter. I won by two. We was down. It was all at the end. It was all game to lose. Our players were dogs, man. I made a couple adjustments. I had to play people more times than I needed to, than I wanted to, but I needed to. And we ended up putting one of the best games in the tournament by that victory. And then from there, we used that victory to kind of propel us to our next win.
Enjoy the trip. Good trip.
Head home, man.
Get out of here.